out what a motherfucking boss look like, you looking at him. Period. It ain't dark right now. Feel off, but I like it. Comfort in my sense, not about me. Hey, babes.
Hey.
Welcome back to my channel. It's your girl, Sonia K, and I'm back with another video, period. Today, y'all, we are at the tea party. Me and Naja are panelists. We're so, so excited. Well, I know for me. I don't know about for Naja, but I think for Naja, too. On my vision board, I have put speak on a panel. Did you?
I didn't put it on there, but I always talk about doing it.
Okay. Put it on my vision board, and it's just March, and we already speaking on our first panel together, which is such a blessing. I'm just so grateful for the opportunity God has put us in, mm-hmm. because we really them girls for real.
Yeah.
But you want to know what a boss look like? You look.
Dang, what is getting so bright for?
You want to know what a motherfucking boss look like? You looking at them.
Period.
Cashing going to be...
You want a boss of your life?
It's Miss Boss. It's Miss Boss to you.
Dang, I don't got no caption yet.
Oh, I had multiple ones. Hold on. What the other one was? Other one was, you want to know what a boss looks like.
I can't see.
Oh.
Now she got on purple. I got on green.
Y'all, I'm mad that I don't have a pearl necklace on.
I had an extra necklace I could have brought her, but I didn't think she needed it, so I didn't bring it.
But yeah, we look so cute. We really look like church first ladies, like.
No, my other dress, y'all would have seen it.
That was given like, first lady.
No, but it was a mess. I can't lie.
That dress was not a mess.
To me, it was.
Yeah. Me and Naja are speaking on a segment together. So we're going to be up there together so that way Zoe don't got to record twice. Okay?
We're going to do a fit check, too.
Yeah, we
gotta
do a fit check.
Y'all
got to
see this.
We're going to do a fit check with our heels on, though. Because I got on slippers right now. Soften up the mess. Drop it in the water, let the daughter find her image with the rest. She'll be learning how to breathe. Spinning through identity, reveal another pretty little scheme. Save her mind. Hold her hand. And don't believe a lie, you understand me. Walk her down the valley. Pack a piece of heaven for the bottoms of her feet. Teach her how to jump and how to stretch when she reach, like the angels do. And you gon' make it through now. Tell about the healer. Greater is the one within and call him as the leader. Teach her how to hold a pretty end up to the sky. Heavenly Father God, I just wanna thank you for gracing us to see another day, God. Thank you for protecting it.
Wanted you was an outcast. Everybody had them counted you out. But praise be unto God that God stepped down and he came and he saw about you. That's how he operate. That's how he get down. And so by him getting down for me, I get down for him. And listen, let me tell you something. I don't have to fight nobody, you understand? Because it's flesh and blood that we don't fight. It's flesh and blood that we don't battle up against. But I go toe to toe any day with me a demon from hell. Because he has given me the power. He has given me dominion. Curiosity. When we don't know, when we unsure, you're supposed to ask God, God, why am I here? You're supposed to ask God, God, who am I? You're supposed to ask God, where am I going? Because see, in church they will tell you, you're not supposed to question God. But I detest that fact, because if I'm not to ask God, where am I going, then why would he give me how? That's a question. Why would he give me where? That's where I'm going. Why would he give, you understand? So I question God. But when I question him in reverence, because he's holy, because he's divine. And so I just want every woman in here to be edified and to know that God is, God will always do, God will never leave you forsake you. He'll come and get you out the mire and clay. He will grab you up out the dirt. Because, baby, I was once in the dirt. I was once didn't know who the hell I was. But look at me now. I'm not Letitia James, a transformer for nothing.
So what I want you to do, I need you to look at one of your sisters and say, we about to go somewhere.
I started off in 2021 of November. I was fired from Walmart and I joined the Amazon Influencer Program. And from there, I just started building my content on TikTok. I gave myself like 6 months before I started looking for another job. But I really didn't have big girl bills at the time. So that's why I gave myself 6 months just to see if I could even do it or if I liked it or something I was interested into. And it was, so from there, I just blew up on TikTok. And in 2021, it was way easier to grow on TikTok than it is now.
You said that 2021 was easier to grow on TikTok. Can you tell us why? What's the difference between then and now?
The algorithm was different in 2021. It was easier to just post a video with a trending sound. You didn't have to add a caption. You didn't have to put any edits to it. It was just post a video and go, and it could blow up overnight. Starting off, what I tell people to do is write it down. Like every time you're posting, if I'm posting today at 2 o'clock, I'm gonna write it down and I'm gonna pay attention to whether it did good. Did it get comments? Did people like it? Did they save it? And then the next day, I might try a different time and do that for like 2 weeks and then go back and see, okay, these are my good times and stick to that.
And I noticed that certain things that I post, they may not get as much engagement, but then there are other posts that get like, I feel like I went viral. But how do I know exactly, and this is my question, I know I'm going to wait, but how do I know if I should just only post this type of content versus the other content that is not getting the engagement that I would like it to have or get?
So starting off, what I tell people is, you're posting for you because you have to like what you do, obviously, but you're also posting for your audience. So if something doesn't work, stop doing it. Like, that's not what they like. That's not what they're engaged into. What works, do that. Then when you start to build a community and people are engaging with your content, you have the same women or men engaging with your videos, then you can start throwing in other things and they're going to attract to it because they're already your community, basically.
That charm community. All right, I'm going to build me a community. Y'all understand what she just said? All right.
Today, I spoke on my very first panel as a full-time content creator and influencer, and I can literally only thank God for opportunities like this. I'm so blessed and so grateful to be in the position that I'm in, and I cannot wait to see what more God has in store for me.